Audio isn't the only thing that got improved in Final Cut Pro 10.3. Apple made workflow improvements across the board.
In this lesson, we'll look at a new timecode effect, two great new effects-related commands, and a powerful new transition effect. Welcome back. Now we're going to look at some effects improvements in Final Cut Pro 10.3. First off, I'm going to go to the effects browser, and in the basics category, there's a brand new timecode effect. I'll put it on this first clip and open the inspector, and we can see that the timecode base by default is set to source. So now we have an easy way to see source timecode for every clip in your project. There are several parameters available to make it very easy to customize it, but the key benefit here is being able to see source timecode. I'll move it over here a little bit. I'll copy this clip. I'll press Command-Alt to select the rest of them, and then Command-Click this first one to deselect it, and then Shift-Command-V for paste attributes, and I'll choose to paste just the timecode effect to the rest of my clips. And now I have source timecode on every clip in my project. So now I could export this version for perhaps a director or producer review if they had notes based on source timecode. Now, before I continue with this edit, I'm going to want to remove that source timecode effect. So Final Cut Pro now has an easy way to do that. If I go to the Edit menu, we see two new commands, Remove Effects and Remove Attributes. Remove Effects is very powerful because it will remove every single effect applied to every selected clip, but it's also somewhat dangerous if you're not sure what effects you have applied to your clips. So I generally prefer to use the new and sorely needed Remove Attributes command. It brings up the Remove Attributes dialog where you can choose specifically what attributes that have been applied to your clips that you want to remove. And in this case, I want to keep color correction and only remove timecode. By the way, you may have noticed in the Edit menu the new Copy Timecode command. We go into more depth on ways you can use this in workflows in our What's New in-depth tutorial. Another fantastic new effect in Final Cut Pro 10.3 is a transition. I have here a short clip that I want to cut down and remove some of the mistakes and ums and ahs. So let's do a quick cut down on this interview clip.
But I think the love of flight...
So I remove that right there. I'll Command Plus to zoom in a little bit.
Flight...
I'll set an in point.
Really...
And an out point and delete. Shift Z, let's play a little bit more.
Really began at a very young age. Nobody in my family really wanted to fly. It was just something I looked at the sky.
So he has an incomplete sentence here that starts right about here.
Nobody in my family.
So I'll set an endpoint here.
Nobody in my family really wanted to fly. It was just something I.
And we'll go right to where that thought stops. Press O and delete.
I looked at the sky one time, saw an aircraft up there, and thought, wow, that must be incredible to be able to see what they're seeing.
And he has one little pause right here. I'll Command Plus a few times to zoom into that. Pause. I. O. And delete. So I've made three cuts, and let's play this through now and take a close look at our talent as he's talking.
But I think the love of flight really began at a very young age. I looked at the sky one time, saw an aircraft up there, and thought, wow, that must be incredible to be able to see what they're seeing from the air.
So we have some very obvious jump cuts that we would normally need to cover with B-roll. But now we've got a great way to handle this. If I go to the Transitions browser, in the Dissolves category, we have a new Flow transition, which is made specifically to merge together little breaks in interview footage or any talking footage. So I'll select all the clips in between and double-click to apply it to every edit point. And that's it. Let's go ahead and play and check it out.
But I think the love of flight really began at a very young age. I looked at the sky one time, saw an aircraft up there, and thought, wow, that must be incredible to be able to see what they're seeing from the air.
So it's pretty incredible. It almost works like magic. You can change the default duration amount of the transition, but it pretty much works perfectly out of the box.